Philips is a technology company that aims to improve the lives of people and make the world healthier and more sustainable through innovation. We do that by focusing on three product groups, which is our healthcare equipment, our consumer products, and our lighting equipment. And in our way of doing business, we really take a dual approach. We look at both the healthy people and sustainable planet. We think if we want to achieve our sustainability goals, we need to shift from a linear economy to a circular economy, and recycled plastics is really a key element of that strategy.
What you can see here is our newest introduction. It's the Perfect Care Aqua Eco. It's an addition to the very, very successful Perfect Care Aqua range. And it comes with the main technology that made the Philips very well known in the world of steam generators, optimal temp, meaning you don't see a dial because you don't need it anymore. You just don't need to adjust the temperature. You can even leave the iron on the ironing board or on your garment. Nothing will burn. What is new in the product is that we this time decided to bring in as much recycled plastics as possible. So more than half of the plastics you can see here are from recycled material. So we are using mainly three different kinds of plastics in the Perfect Care Aqua Eco. It's PBT, PC, and PP. You can, for example, see if you look at the iron housing, the black part, it's made of recycled PC. Or if you have a look more at the button, you can see the black part or the green part, which is also a big part inside, that would be recycled PP. We first of all look at the components of the product where we can recycle most, so looking at the bigger parts. We could obviously look at the small parts, but first of all our view is always on the big parts where we can make a larger impact. Then we also have to see, obviously, will the material work with recycled plastics, because some of the components will be in contact with heat. You can imagine an iron has a lot of heat, the soap plate has a lot of heat. So some of the components need to have special specifications that maybe are not met with recycled materials. I can give you a good example about the tray. We wanted to change that one. And we went to our supplier and asked them if they could try to make it with recycled plastic. That is the outcome. You unfortunately see a lot of gaps that consumers would not accept. And what you also can see is a lot of difference in the aesthetics. So the shine, the premiumness we have on this black is unfortunately not there anymore for the tray if it comes from recycled material. The design for the steam generator changes a bit with the knowledge that now we will bring in recycled material. For example, we purposely decided for a darker color because it's a bit easier to hide impurities with a dark color. We then matched it together with a very nice green that gives a nice contrast. So in the end, we have a very good looking, very nice premium looking product where we were able to have the highest content of recycled materials possible. Well, working with the supplier actually means a lot of back and forth, a lot of trying and sometimes also failing. What we do is we give them what we would like to have. So we have our specifications in terms of what's needed, heat resistance, shineness. We give it to the supplier, they give it a try. We see a lot of errors, we see gaps, we see some shrinkage happening, and then we need to go back and forth, check together and find a solution in the end. But it's not something that happens within a week. It's a progress that takes a month, and we then luckily can take those learnings also for other products.
We will definitely continue our efforts on recycled plastics. So last year in 2014 we used around 625 tons and we aim to bring that to 3500 tons in 2016. We think we can do that, but it will still require a lot of innovation, especially if we want to have more color freedom in the plastics, but also if we would like to see recycled plastics in food contact or skin contact parts, that will really require more innovation. That would also require other companies to join the effort. Recycling companies will only be able to really innovate and invest in innovation if they have a big enough market. So we as Philips, we truly believe that we can be successful in recycled plastics if other companies join us in our efforts.